guys. Well, I'm out in the shop today, and I'm just kind of trying to get everything pre-assembled and checked out. As you can see, it moves up and down really nice. I've got the ball screw in here. Turned out really well. The PVC pipe that I put in there, I was kind of just sort of guessing the location there, but I think I got it pretty good. I think if I had to do it over again, I'd put, that's a 3/4 inch piece of PVC, I'd probably put a 1 inch just to give me a little room there. When I've got the connecting, the Z-axis ball nut connector rod and ball nut mount all connected. Don't know if you can see up in there, maybe. I've got all that hooked up and lined up. It turned out really well. You can see we're off up over the top there, and that is all the way up right there. Quite a bit of extra height there, maybe an inch or so extra travel, which is nice. And you can see the ball screw goes down far enough to where this will go all the way down and probably come off the rails here. However, with the spindle on there, that distance right here is going to close up. So from here to here is about 6 inches. So I don't think I'm going to have a problem. Once I get the table and everything on here, I can probably sit that spindle right down on the table. So that's going to give me a good bit of Z travel there. Right now I'm in the process of just sort of buttoning things up and sorting things out. There's a lot that goes into just trying to figure out how all this stuff gets put together and how it's going to work out. The bolts that come through here to mount the gearbox and the spindle are M12s, and so it's going to be kind of tight right here to get a wrench inside here. So I'm going to have to take this back off, and I'm going to recess a hex pocket in here so that the bolt head will be countersunk, and that'll also hold the head of the bolt while I tighten up the nut. Something that I didn't think about when I designed the saddle originally. It's not a big deal. I'll put it back in the machine. I'll index off the center hole there. And I want to show you the ball screw. I don't have any kind of wobble here. It's nice and true. So I'm pretty pleased with that. These are the holes here for the grease fittings. There's on the top and on the bottom. I've got to figure out a way to centralize a zerk fitting somewhere. Most likely it's going to be on the bottom or the sides. You can see I have a fitting there. However, there's not a lot of room in between the two, so I don't know exactly how I'm going to tie all four blocks. Plus, I want to also pick up the ball nut back here. So I'll grease all of those at the same time with that one grease fitting. I thought about oil versus grease, and I think grease is going to be the better way to go. I really don't like the oil lubrication system I've got on the original machine. It gets all in my coolant, and it just creates a mess. So if all possible, I want to have a grease system on here, and I think the grease will hold up a little bit better. So there's quite a bit of little bitty projects that are going to be coming up working on this Z-axis. I want to get this buttoned up first before I move forward with the X and the Y. So I'm also working on a counterbalance system using some air springs, something that my buddy Wyatt was working on and he never finished, and so I'm going to try to take his ideas and implement them into this project. I think you'll be pretty surprised at what he came up with. It's a little bit different than what I've seen before, so I haven't seen anything quite like it, and I think it'll work out just fine. So I got to try to figure out how to implement that. Because I'm going to have the jag chain here, and also eventually, hopefully, an ATC on the side there. So space is limited, and we were going to have to figure all that out. Hey guys, well, we're back in the shop today, and I've got the Z-axis saddle back in the machine. We're going to be doing hex head countersinks on these three holes, and we're also going to be drilling and tapping five holes down here. And we're going to incorporate an oil manifold in the saddle so that I can lubricate the linear blocks. Now, this would have been better off done when it was in the fixture. However, I didn't realize I was going to be doing this. This is all part of the process when you're converting these machines. But the two linear blocks are going to be sitting here, and with the oil fittings attached, it's going to be kind of tight getting a wrench in here and trying to tighten this up. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to countersink it so the head will fit down in there. That'll help hold it on the back side. I won't have to worry about getting a wrench in there. And then I can just tighten it up on the front side. We're going to be putting five holes down here. We're going to put some M5 90 degree elbows in here. And the oil lines will come up through here and loop around and go into the four linear guides. It's also going to come down the connecting rod and attached to the ball screw, and then I will drill a hole in the side and tap it with a zerk fitting here, or a grease fitting, so I can just squeeze in the grease and it'll just transfer to the ball screw and the linear blocks. So let's get this machine. We're going to machine some pockets here. We've got the G-code in Mach 3 here, and you can see we've got some countersink pockets here, and then we're going to do some boring and some thread milling for those five holes down there at the bottom. All right, so let's get started. guys. Well, all right. Well, that should work out nicely. Nice and flush. Very good. I've got these little barb fittings. I wasn't sure what I was going to use, but make sure they fit in there. Oh yeah. Nice. Now I've got some ordered that are banjo style, and it'll be pointing at a 90 degree angle like this, and I think that'll fit in there. Okay, so we went and threaded that for an M6. This M6. There we go. M6. And we're going to put a grease fitting in there. Alright, well, I didn't have enough Z travel on my machine to get this long drill bit in there, so I just went back through and drilled it by hand. So now we just need to install our grease fittings. However, I know there's going to be other things that I need to mount to this, so we'll probably have to come back later and drill some more holes. So let's take it back out to the mill and see what we got. All right, guys, so we got the saddle machined out. I did the reset for the bolts. That way they'll be flush and I can just tighten up the nut from the front side here. I'm not sure if I have bolts long enough. I haven't quite figured out what the spacer distance is going to be between the saddle and the gearbox. Because the linear rails and blocks push the saddle out further than the original, I'm thinking I only need a 1-inch spacer like I had on the original conversion. But I won't know until I get the XY saddle sorted out and figure out what the travel is going to be on that. Ideally, I want to have the center of the spindle at the center of my Y travel here, and then that way I'll be able to get around the largest part I can. I've ordered some banjo fittings like this. These are M6 and they're gonna go in here. I need M5 for this manifold, so they'll go in there like so, and then the hose is going to connect to that and then go up to the top of the bottom bearing blocks here. These are some barb fittings. I wasn't quite sure if I should use barbs or these banjo, but the banjos are kind of bulky, so I'm going to try to use these barb fittings. I was a little concerned that the hose may pull off, but there's not really going to be a whole lot of pressure, and it's very difficult to pull these off without getting a couple of pair of needle nose or something and yanking on it. So I think we're going to be all right. And then it'll screw into the bottom of the top blocks and then come down and pick up this banjo fitting. And these two are for this side. And then the center one will just come along, follow the connecting pin here, and connect to my ball nut. And that way the ball nut and the blocks will all get lubricated at the same time. They'll just kind of follow along and catch the fitting on the inside. That's just a M6 thread push to connect fitting for, I'm using 4mm tubing. And then for the linear blocks, we have this screw on the top here. This is an M4. I'm going to have to re-tap these to accept my M5 threaded barb here. And then the top one will go in like so. Very difficult to find M4 threads for any kind of hose fitting, so I'm going to just re-tap these to M5. So hopefully in the next video I'll have this all buttoned up. I am concerned that how to connect all the holes and bolt it up. I don't want to leave myself too much slack in the hose. However, I'm going to have enough slack to where I can make these connections. But I'll get that all sorted out. So in the next video, I'm going to probably start working on a counterbalance system for this. I'm going to be going with an air spring, and we'll talk about that more in the next video. Thanks for watching, guys. Those of you who are new to my channel and just tuning in, click on the subscribe button. That way, every time I post a new video, you'll get notified, and if it's something you're interested in, you can stop by and check it out. Thanks for watching, guys. Please subscribe, and most importantly, be safe.